Good morning, chaps. Welcome along to the vlog. And it appears today that after having a board meeting this morning with Gemma and Stu to put together all of the HR documents and everything like that, I've come into work to jump straight back on to repairing the cask chiller. And I've had a look for a 24 volt AC power supply unit, and they're about 25 bloody quid, you know, to replace this thing that's fried on us. So I'm not happy about that kind of moolah, to be fair. So I've been looking at what I've got in here. This is kind of a bag of tricks that I've got. This is an 11.4 volt AC dimmable electronic transformer. I don't really think that's going to cut the mustard because it's only running, come on, focus please. It's only running at 11.4 volts. So digging around in here, we've got an old transformer here, just that's DC. Again, that's no good. I've also got some spare circuit boards down here. So looking at this, this is a transformer on a power supply unit, but whilst it was a 24 volt power supply unit, 180 watt, it's DC. You can tell, look, because it's got all the capacitors down here and a rectifier, bridge rectifier and all that kind of jazz. So again, that's no good for us. And then here we have a transformer on this piece of kit. So this came out of the scales that I fried accidentally. But again, I think this is a no-go because it's a 0 to 115 volt. So I think the output side on this is probably too much. And I don't know what to tap where. So again, I'll be playing with something. Playing with fire. Oh, there we go. So it's 115 volts in. So that must have gone through a transformer already to supply the power. And then it's an 8 volt AC output. Again, that's no good to me. So I don't think I've got anything that'll do it. I basically need to order one of these. But I don't know if it's going to have the power to operate that fan outside. Would it be easier, do you think, to change that fan just to a DC fan? And run it that way instead? I don't know. Anyway, I'm going to continue to have a look through all the little boxes of tricks that I've got, and I've got a few, and see if I can come up with a solution. If not, I'm going to have to bite the bullet and go ahead and buy a 24 volt AC transformer. 25 quid seems a lot of money, man. So I've done a little bit of research. It turns out these are called toroidal power supplies, and you can get them in 12 and 24 volts. This one says it's 100 volt amps, which is about 100 watts, I believe. But I'm not very confident about putting another one of these back in. So instead, I've ordered one of these, which is obviously a normal transformer, encapsulated, I think they call them, something like that. So we've got 100 volt amps, and it's going to be 240 to 24 volts. AC. We'll pop that in when it arrives and see if that actually does the job in sorting out our problem. Hopefully it will. I feel like testing this bugger. Look at all the taps that come off it. If I knew a little bit more about these transformers, I wonder if I could actually get 24 volts out of this one. But we'll just order one so I don't electrocute myself. Wouldn't want that to happen now, would we? Alright, so let's just rotate the camera. I'm thinking about going out there into the pub and doing a little bit of repair work, because there is a lock missing on the ladies' toilets and people are worried about having shit stolen out of it. Not really. And we've got to do some touch up on some paint in there, so let's get on with that. Well, one thing that we've got to do today is ice machine maintenance. So this is in the workshop. There seems to be a little bit of lime scale. Maybe not. I don't think it needs descaling. Just a tiny little bit of corrode there. So it's actually really clean inside. I'm really pleased with that. I mean, you're not going to see this in a lot of pub ice machines. Generally, all behind here is all black and manky. This one has been well looked after. And I thought, he said the ice cube size has reduced a little bit. So I thought, oh, maybe it's a small problem with maybe the heat exchange getting a touch bunged up. Well, there's a little bit of dust on there, but nothing really too bad. So let's just go ahead and, oh yeah. Could be then. I mean, for the price of the machine, it's not exactly a really expensive heat exchange on there. So we'll pop that back in, run a little bit of cleaner through it, and see how we get on. So, Stu wants me to put a door closer on one of the kitchen doors. We've got some spare ones in here, as well as a load of other crap. And we really need to get rid of the crap from upstairs. It's getting beyond a joke now. So something like that. I'm never gonna use that, so let's bin it. A humidity dial. I suppose we can keep that and pop it somewhere. And then of course we have two door closers here. So I can go and install one of these onto said door. I tell you what, folks, it's bloody amazing how little you get done in a day when you've got to do admin and you're rushing around from A to B to pick up stuff. So I've had to just shoot home to get some light bulbs, because all three light bulbs, which were halogen, I don't like halogen, all three of them have gone on this light fitting. Little. And the small Edison screw. So they're like the most awkward ones. Anyway, I managed to get some LEDs. I don't think anyone's going to really care too much about them looking a little bit horrible. Horrible golf ball ones. Right, that's two. And that's three. Let's go and turn the light on. And, oh shit, I shouldn't have done that. Oh, bollocks. Let's go and turn the light on and see how that looks. It's not too bad. They do look a little bit ropey like. Have a look. They're just the horrible golf ball stylies. But never mind. There we go, folks. The brew shed. Right, I better take this ladder down now and get rid of everything. So I'll turn all the lights off again so I don't have to come back up. So now I'm gonna get a little bit of brick acid, and we're going to remove the staining from yesterday's block work. I'll tell you what though, I need hose pipe, Jem. Do you want to pull it out for me? Have it turned on? Put the brick acid in here and it's full of cement dust, it'll just neutralise it straight away. Probably deal with that scrubbing brush that you've got. Yeah, I'll give that a whirl, it might be a little bit better. This is splashing all over my legs. Getting acidified. Oh well, I've just finished brick acid in the wall and it looks spot on. Unfortunately I can't go in there and show you it because there's a load of customers sat in the beer garden. It's 4:30 and it's sunny as frig. So instead, we're going to have to finish off the vlog in here until maybe we get a break in the beer garden and I can take the camera through without people thinking I'm a perv. So, almost done for the day. It's approaching 5:00 and I don't have a lift home at the moment, so I've just fired up the glue gun and we're going to just carry on bitting and bobbing with these control panels for the fermenters for when we get round to getting them all welded up. So I ordered a ton of these relays. Let's have a look if I can remember what the name of them are. It should be printed on here somewhere. LY2NJ. So these are the double pole, double throw 240, it's going to be difficult to focus on this in this light, double pole, double throw, 240 volt relays. So I've talked about these before, but what I do with them is to make them last a little bit longer, we just ping the covers off, and inside they have a resistor. Let me just get some snips. We'll get some snips and we'll focus right down on this. So inside they have a resistor and an LED, and that resistor and LED actually pulls more current than the coil itself. So what I like to do is just take them out just like this, there we go, and completely remove it. So now they don't overheat and they last a considerable lot longer. You know what I mean? They last a considerable amount of time longer than if I hadn't actually removed that little LED and its control resistor, so, or its current limiting resistor. So we're just going to pop these together and they go in a row at the bottom of the boxes like this. So I'm just going to do this for a while until Gemma arrives, essentially. Thank you. Hello, madam. Where's that trouble causer? I knew it! You're a little tank elf, aren't you? Going behind the tanks.
Tank elf.
That has got the vacant tin, which I'm thinking about bottling. So I'm going to hold it at 15 degrees. And then we can bottle from there.
Just because
you... I'm calling that one. But yeah, and we can bottle it in these bad boys. And if I can get some labels sorted, might be able to send it to a few bottle shops or actually sell them online. So I'm just having a slurpy poo. Can you see me?
No, a little bit, yeah.
I'm just having a slurp on Tiny Rebel and Neon Raptor Sorbet IPA, which Stuart bought in the Tiny Rebel birthday pack. It does taste like sorbet. It's a little bit sour. Anyway, as you can hear, Gem's arrived. We're off home. See you on tomorrow's vlog. We brought this sink home, hoping that we can utilize it for making sausages and experimenting and stuff. But I can't plumb it in because the closest drain, unfortunately, kind of there. See there? So I don't really fancy digging up and putting it there. So if anyone's got any ideas how I can plumb this sink in, just let me know. Are you going on your swings, Abs? Wonderful. Right, well there we go then. It's a lovely day. I'm gonna get a beer, sit in what's left of this fantastic sunshine, and chill out. We'll see you on tomorrow's vlog.